Hello and welcome back to Super PWRD, the show where we bring you the top news stories in playing, watching, reading, and doing. This week's episode is brought to you by Geek Bomb's Punderwear store, where you can get yourself a load of punny gear. I'm your host Dean Abdu, where we've got all sorts of tea to spill, such as Fallout 76 being announced by Bethesda Game Studios, and a tweet this week that got us hyped for Matt Reeves' The Batman. So let's dive straight in. Bethesda has surprised fans by officially announcing the next entry in its beloved Fallout franchise, Fallout 76. They've kind of missed a couple of games there from Fallout 4 to get to 76, but you know, whatever, you know, they can do them. It's fine. After a day of online teasers, a brief trailer was dropped which featured the mythical Vault 76 setting which fans have heard about from Fallout 3. But as Bethesda boss Todd Howard said before it debuted, this trailer was only meant as a tease. However, the rumour mill has been turning again, and there are a few reports online talking about how Fallout 76 might be going down the route of the online survival kind of genre inspired by the likes of Rust and Conan Exiles. These are just rumours though, so we kind of just gotta sit back and wait patiently until Bethesda's E3 showcase where we'll get some more info. Some DC film news rumours for you guys now. According to Variety film reporter Justin Kroll, Warner Brothers are eyeing up the Penguin to be the main big bad in Matt Reeves' The Batman. Now, there's the potential that Reeves could just scrap that and go a complete different direction, but according to sources, the Penguin has also been pitched in one of the multiple scripts that have been submitted for the Margot Robbie-led film Birds of Prey. Warner seems to be pretty keen in bringing back the Penguin after Danny DeVito's performance in Tim Burton's Batman, but I mean, why wouldn't you? That man was fantastic in that film. The only request I have is that if you're going to bring back the Penguin, bring back Danny DeVito as well. That brilliant little man has to do that role. No one else can. Good news for lovers of fantasy novels. It seems that Jennifer Fox, a producer from films such as Nightcrawler, The Bourne Legacy, and Michael Clayton, has optioned the film rights to the Earthsea franchise by the late and great Ursula K. Le Guin. For those of you who are unfamiliar, the Earthsea universe is right up there with Middle-earth, but hasn't been given nearly the same level of mainstream awareness. Either way, this turn of events promises that one day the fascinating stories of Earthsea will get their time in the sun and our big screens, and not just terrible watered-down miniseries versions of it. Looking at you, sci-fi from 2004. For doing this week, we asked you guys what your May powers are. You can head on over to Geek Bomb's Twitter and Instagram accounts to see what the Bomb Squad have been playing, watching, reading, and doing this month. But why don't you let us know what you've been up to? Let us know what you've been playing, watching, reading, and doing. All things geeky, non-geeky, just the whole shebang. So that's all for this week. Let us know in the comments down below if you're excited for Matt Reeves' The Batman. And a big thank you to the Geek Bomb Underwear Store for being this week's sponsor. They pun smash fandoms all across the galaxy, from Star Wars to Nintendo, from Dungeons & Dragons to Marvel, from Game of Thrones to Back to the Future. They also carry some delicious designs from Geek Bomb's Fungeons & Flagons series and exclusive Smordcast merch. So head on over to punderwear.net to snag yourself some very punny gear. I'm Dean Abdu and I'll see you next week for more powered news.